In this screencast, we're going to run through a reactor problem involving a recycle stream around the reactor and perform the necessary material balances on our system to answer a couple questions. So the first place to start with any material balance is to start with a schematic of our process. So we have our reactor. We know into our reactor we have a mixture of butane and oxygen. We have our product stream leaving our reactor. This is going to contain unreacted butane, unreacted oxygen, CO2, CO, and water. This is going to enter our separator, which takes 90% of the unreacted butane and oxygen and passes it back into a mixing point, where it joins a fresh feed of butane and oxygen. This means we also have a product waste stream, which will also contain all of the components entering the separator, since not all of the butane and oxygen is separated. So to be clear, we have a feed stream of butane and oxygen that gets mixed with a recycle stream of butane and oxygen that then enters our reactor. Coming out of our reactor, we have butane, oxygen, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and water. And then out of our separator, we have all five of those species as well that exit as a waste stream. If it's a waste stream, why have a reactor at all? Since we're combusting butane, we're probably doing that to generate heat for some other part of our process. So now that we have our diagram set up, we should fill in our details from our problem statement. So now we have most of the information we can put into our schematic, we can start setting up our material balances and figuring out what other information we may need to determine to solve those balances. Now the first part of the problem asks us to determine the composition of the product gas from the reactor, so the flow rates in the stream. Knowing the flow rates, we can then divide by the total molar flow to get our composition. But you can see we have five unknowns. So we need to at least determine some of these unknowns before we move on with solving our material balances. First thing we could do is solve for our molar flow rate of oxygen that enters our reactor, because we're told that the butane is burned with 25% excess oxygen. We need to write our combustion reaction. So we have butane plus oxygen. Theoretically, complete combustion will give us CO2 and water. So now we need to balance this reaction. Therefore, since we have 100 moles of butane entering per hour, we would need 6.5 moles of oxygen per mole of butane to get our theoretical need. That's 650 moles of oxygen per hour. Since we're using 25% excess, we know that the amount of oxygen into our reactor is going to be 1.25 times our theoretical, or 812.5 moles of oxygen per hour. The single pass conversion gives us an idea of how much butane comes out of the reactor. If we write this out, our fractional conversion, 0.45, must equal the amount of moles of butane that come in, 100, minus how much comes out. So this is our NB in our product stream. And this is over how much comes in, our 100. So really, this is how much is consumed per how much enters, or therefore a single pass conversion. So to solve for the amount of butane that leaves in our product stream, we get 55 moles per hour. At this point, we have three unknowns. And since we have three different elements, oxygen, carbon, and hydrogen, we could use an atomic species balance for those three elements to solve for our three unknowns. Now, unfortunately, we can't do an extended reaction method because we do not know the reaction to perform carbon monoxide, unless this was something you wanted to look up on your own. Since we don't have that information here in the problem statement, we're going to use an atomic species balance to solve for this reaction. So let's start with a hydrogen balance. Again, we're doing this all over the reactor. So we have hydrogen that comes in the butane, C4H10. So for each mole of butane, we have 10 moles of hydrogen. Leaving, we also have hydrogen in our butane. We also have hydrogen in our water. For each mole of water, we have 2 moles of hydrogen. So 100 moles of butane per hour times 10 moles of hydrogen per mole of butane has to be equal to what's coming out. In this case, we know that there are 55 moles of butane per hour coming out of our reactor. So again, 10 moles of hydrogen per mole of butane. This is going to be plus our moles of water, which we don't know, and H2O in our product stream. And there are 2 moles of hydrogen per mole of water. So you can see we have one unknown, our flow rate of water, and we can solve for this. To get 225 moles of water per hour. So now we could write a carbon balance. Again, we have carbon in our butane, and leaving our reactor, we have it in our butane, our carbon dioxide, and our carbon monoxide. So our balance would look like the following. When you look at this balance, you see we have two unknowns, the flow rates of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. So we couldn't solve it unless we knew a ratio between the two, which were given in the problem statement. So we could plug that information in here where we have 9 times more carbon dioxide than we do carbon monoxide. Now we could solve for the flow rate of carbon monoxide in our product stream, and we get 18 moles of carbon monoxide per hour. Using the ratio information, we could solve for the flow rate of carbon dioxide in our product stream as 9 times that, or 162 moles of carbon dioxide per hour. Now, we did a carbon and hydrogen balance. The last thing we could do is an oxygen balance to determine the amount of oxygen leaving the reactor. So when I write this balance, you can see that all the oxygen coming in is due to our gas oxygen being fed. And then out of the reactor, we have 4 different species containing oxygen. Fortunately, only one unknown, that the flow rate of oxygen, so we could solve for the oxygen in our product stream, and we get 529 moles of oxygen gas per hour. So if you recall, the first part of this question asked to determine the composition of our product stream here leaving the reactor. We have all of the flow rates, so we can determine this. Now the first thing is to determine the total molar flow rate leaving in the product stream, which is 989 moles of our product stream per hour. Now to determine the composition or mole fraction in this case, what we're going to do is divide each of these by the total. When we do that, we get a composition of butane as 5.6 mole percent. So if you do this for all of them, you should get the following composition. Unfortunately, this does add up to 100.1 mole percent based on rounding. So the closest one I could probably round down here to 3 significant digits is this last one to make sure that we do have it add up to 100 mole percent. Otherwise, carry it out to more digits to be more accurate. The second part of the question asks us to determine the feed flow rates that are entering this process. What we don't have filled in here now, since we know the product amounts, we can fill in the molar flow rates for both the flow rates of butane and oxygen in our waste stream and recycle stream. So I'll do that really quick just here in the diagram. So now you should be able to see that if we do a material balance on our mixing point, we have 2 unknowns, the feed flow rates of butane and oxygen, and 2 species balances that we can write. So let's go ahead and write those material balances out. So our balance on our mixing point is basically what comes in must go out. So we have, for butane, our fresh feed plus what comes in from the recycle stream must be equal to the total amount leaving. And so we could solve for the fresh butane feed as 50.5 moles of butane per hour. So we do the same thing for oxygen. And so we get the fresh feed amounts of both butane and oxygen that we need for our process. The last part of this question asks to determine our overall butane conversion. And to do that, we start with how much we're feeding into the process. So that's 50.5 moles of butane per hour. We subtract what comes out of our process. This was 5.5 moles of butane per hour in our waste stream. And we divide that by how much we're feeding into the system. This gives us our overall fractional conversion of 0.891 or 89.1% conversion of butane in this process.